You can't have Japanese food without dashi. Yeah. We start with dashi. Yeah.
Yuki Totsuka works as a vet and loves cooking Japanese food using many age-old techniques. She makes her dashi from scratch.
This is the piece of kombu. They come in long strips, so you only need about a 10 centimetre square, so cut it and snip a few extra bits in to let the flavour all come through, and then you soak it in water. That's one I put in about half an hour ago, and it all goes back to its original size. Then we boil that away, probably on sort of medium heat. So when you start seeing little bubbles come up from the side of the kombu, then that's when it's ready for you to take the kombu out. Now, this is the bonito. So it's a piece of the fish that's been boiled and smoked and dried.
Sort of looks like a prosciutto almost.
Almost, yeah. And you have this really nice shiny meat inside. And this is the special shaving tool. Careful with your fingers, but that's how you do it. And then you end up with the flakes in the bottom. And then you put the bonito flakes in.
So is that like one cup of bonito flakes?
Oh, say two big handfuls. And the heat back on. Just sort of when you start seeing the little bubbles. And then we'll turn it off. And then just let it sit and wait till it goes, or all the flakes sink to the bottom of the pan. And then we just strain it through. Yeah, that's it.
That's beautiful.
That's the basic stock. General rule of miso is the darker the colour of the miso, the sort of stronger and sharper the flavour, and lighter it is, sweeter and milder. So that's sort of halfway. There's about a litre of stock in here. It's probably plenty of miso. So you start off with a small amount, and what you do, you just melt the miso in nice and easy. And there you go, that's stock turned into miso soup.
Any seasonal vegetable can be added to make a hearty soup. Yuki's favourite additions are wakame and tofu.
We just have to heat it through.
Wow.
It's very hot.
That is really good.